Brandon, John, hey, congratulations for Shorzy, this new series.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I feel so bad. I'm only talking to two of the three gyms, but this is still all good for us.
Yeah. We're the more important ones anyways.
Right, you're two of the better gyms. So anyways, what do you guys to this series, and how were you brought on board?
Well, I was reached out by email by Kara, who was one of the main ladies for Shorzy. When I first received the email, I kind of thought it was a joke, because obviously I'm not an actor and I wasn't really aware of anything that was going on. So I guess luckily accepted it and was be able to experience. It was an awesome experience for us, and just to keep going from here.
Brandon?
Yeah, same as John. Like Kara, one of the producers called myself, looking for myself and my younger brother Jordan to be a part of the show. And Zach, same as John, like, thought it was a joke. Like, there's no way someone would want my brother and I to be part of a Letterkenny spinoff, which we all know Letterkenny is so popular, and like, why would they want us? So we started talking a little bit more, got to know that what characters they wanted to play and how the show was going to be and how they wanted to make it look like one of the best hockey shows ever. So once we kind of learned more and talked to Kara a bit more, and we were just like honored to be even thought of and asked to be a part of something that is going to be like so cool. So yeah, just like crazy honored, and just feel like just honored, especially part of something that's going to be amazing.
Now, could you both tell us about your backgrounds into hockey and the love of that sport?
Well, you know, we grew up doing it our whole lives. You know, I'm sure I could speak for Brandon as well there. You know, from a young age, we played hockey. We gone to the next level as a professional career, and it kind of shaped us into the people who we are today. Obviously, I think that was a big reason why we were even asked to be on Letterkenny, or sorry, Shorzy, was, you know, due to the fact of our careers and our backgrounds in hockey. You know, myself, I played a 14-year professional hockey career, and with that, a lot of junior hockey, and got to see the world, and you know, it led to an opportunity to be an actor. And you know, the only acting I did prior to this was just maybe the odd commercial here and there for the hockey team, but that was about it.
Yeah, geez, that's a question I could probably go an hour for. Just the quick answer. Yeah, just I grew up like my younger brother Jordan, we're obviously two of the three gyms, and we grew up in Garden River First Nation. Absolutely loved hockey. My father was a local coach for the junior team, the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds. So I was spoiled and lucky enough to be around the game of hockey my whole life, and just growing up on the reserve in Garden River, having access to an outdoor backyard rink that my father built. It's where like I truly fell in love with the game, and like John said, hockey has shaped our entire lives, and you know, it's just like amazing, like I said, to be a part of something so cool, and it's all come from us like just being hockey players and being asked to be part of the show. So if you really think about like just playing professional hockey and then having a chance to do something so cool and to get into the acting world, it's just like, it's a mind trip. I can't believe like we're here talking about being part of such a cool show.
You guys are great playing gyms, because they kept it really simple and a very limited dialogue for both of you. How do you guys feel about that? And do you get jealous that Jordan gets a little bit more dialogue?
I 100% do not get jealous. I said like give him all the lines. I kind of like, I'm gym number two, so I like fall in the middle of both gym one and gym three, John and Jordan. So I'm like in the middle, so I feel like I have the shortest amount of dialogue. So like I'm like give him all the lines, he can say everything. So it perfectly depicts too like how some Indigenous people are, like very just don't say too much sometimes, but like very very passionate and just like love the game of hockey, tough guys. So it perfectly depicts how some Indigenous hockey players are.
What about for you, John? You love this type of role?
Oh yeah, I like to keep it simple. You know, for me, it was, I think the only challenge I had was because I was gym one. I was always the first one speaking, so I really had to pay attention to when to speak, you know. You know, Brandon knew he was following me, and Jordan knew he was following Brandon. So I think Jared Kiso did a really good job of kind of giving me the nod when it was time, you know, because there was times where I say, well, I'm up, you know, so we'd have to read. But no, it was awesome. Like I said, and Brandon said it, it kind of displayed our characters in real life, you know, hard-nosed hockey players that don't say much and just kind of are out there to support the team and protect our teammates. And, you know, it was fun. And then to be bring the hockey aspect of it, you know, I think Brandon, Jordan, and I are the ones that have the most hockey experience on the show. So to be able to, you know, give our tips and our point of views of how it should be, or, you know, what didn't seem real or what seemed real or how we would do it in that situation, I think brought a lot to the show, and it was awesome. It's just great to see the success that the show is going to have.
This show is all known about chirping. Can you guys chirp in real life along with these people, or just like to just watch them and laugh?
I made a career of chirping. You know, I wasn't on the ice as much. I was the guy that was trying to create chirps and create havoc on the ice. So it's something I did. I don't think I was as good as Shorzy at it, but you know, it's still like we were saying earlier, it's hard to not giggle and laugh at some of the one-liners that you hear, and just to be able to take it in and keep a straight face is probably the most difficult task.
Brandon, last word.
Yeah, no, I wasn't a big chirper. I definitely like to get involved in the game, like whether throwing a body hit or getting hit or, you know, getting in the odd fight. I wasn't a big chirper, but I definitely liked getting under people's skin, like through my play. So nowhere near on the line and level of the Shorzy chirps. Those are another level and something that a lot of teams, you'd be surprised, have a Shorzy type of character. So he's like... He was one of my favorites on Letterkenny, and he's one of my favorites on Shorzy.
Most excellent, gentlemen. Hey, thank you very much for speaking to us about Shorzy. Can't wait to for more seasons and have more gyms.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully. Thank you.
Thank you.